you are. It's Cyberchase for real.
I'm on a treasure hunt, looking for mushrooms. One of my favorite things to do with my father is make Chinese hot pot with mushrooms. When I was little, I tried eating mushrooms on salad, but I didn't like them. I changed my mind after I ate cooked mushrooms. I love them, which made me want to learn more about them. So I did some research. In the wild, many kinds of mushrooms grow on or near trees, which mushrooms use as food. Mushrooms then break down dead wood into food trees use to grow. You may see mushrooms growing near trees where you live, but you shouldn't touch or eat wild mushrooms, because some of them can make you sick. Most mushrooms that people cook at home or in restaurants grow on a mushroom farm. I was surprised to learn that a mushroom farm is inside this building. Hey, Austin.
Courtney.
Can you explain why you decided to become a mushroom farmer?
We can grow a lot of mushrooms all year round in a little space using less water and electricity than other crops. Every 2 weeks, we produce 1,000 pounds. Within hours after we pick them, we deliver our mushrooms to nearby grocery stores and restaurants. This means they're fresh, and we don't use fossil fuel that pollutes to ship mushrooms long distances.
Why do you grow mushrooms in these tents?
Well, outside, we can't control the weather. But in these tents, we can control the light, the moisture, and the airflow to make the perfect environment for mushrooms to grow. Mushroom spores are like the seeds of plants. They sprout out of material that we make from sawdust, which comes from trees cut down for lumber. Over time, spores create mycelium. Eventually, mushrooms will pop out in all different shapes and colors. People who know about mushrooms call these fruit.
I was excited to learn from Austin that it's possible to grow mushrooms using something you might already have around the house, cardboard. Because like sawdust, cardboard is made from trees. That means that you can be a mushroom farmer too.
To start, heat up a small pot of water to a boil. A trusted adult needs to help with this. While the water is heating up, shred some cardboard. When water comes to a boil, remove it from the heat and carefully place the cardboard in the hot water. This will kill any germs on the cardboard. While waiting for the water to cool down, crush a ready-to-fruit block that you can buy that contains mycelium, sawdust, and nutrients into tiny pieces. Next, fill a container like this with layers of cooled-down cardboard and crushed up pieces of your ready-to-fruit block. Once you have filled the container, lightly press down on the material. Wet the lid of the container before loosely putting it on top. Mushrooms need moisture to grow. Remove the lid 2 times a day to make sure the material inside stays damp. When you begin to see tiny mushrooms popping up, mist them with a spray bottle a couple times a day. Here's what you can expect to see after 3 days, after 1 week, and after 3 weeks.
So this is one way to see how trees turned into cardboard help mushrooms grow. Out in the forest, mushrooms help trees by turning dead wood into rich soil, which trees use to grow. That's what I call a win-win.
Watch your favorite shows anytime on the PBS KIDS video app.